teeth down the back of your throat. Well, the choice, Cena, is yours.
I think I'd take option A.
Here are fans here saying one by one, and I think that's John's decision.
John Cena going to run the Nexus Gauntlet, I believe. Heath Slater first up. John Cena wasting a little time. Now, King, Cena knows what Nexus can do as a group, so I think he liked his odds better taking them on individually.
Yeah, is he going to continue to stand here on our announce table?
Oh, I don't see him going anywhere. As Cena, look at this, and a kick at it, too, by Heath Slater. Slater, a 232-pounder from West Virginia.
Well, for John to be anywhere, near successful, he's going to have to put away these guys quickly.
Oh, look at Slater just trying to battle back into this thing. Cena can ill afford to lose here with all the other members of Nexus hovering at ringside. The leader, Wade Barrett, who eliminated Cena last night, is watching just a few feet away from Cena here on our announce table.
Well, we know how bad John Cena wants to face Barrett, but this is looking like it's almost an impossibility now.
And look at this again. Slater cover hooked the leg on Cena. 2 kick out. Not surprised, though, King, that Wade Barrett had a plan. Remember, these other members of Nexus are fresh. Cena went through the 6-pack challenge last night.
Oh, wow.
Victory over Cena would be a feather in any cap of any individual of Nexus.
I'm just saying that John, in order to be successful, he should have already beaten this guy.
Look again as Nexus looks on. Cena powers at it, too. And King to expand on that.
Well, he's taking too long with Heath Slater. For John to be successful, he was going to have to beat these guys quickly. And as you said, stay fresh.
Well, Heath Slater can beat John Cena. Any one of these members of John Cena individually, I should say, if Nexus can beat Cena individually. Look at Slater, top rope. Oh, Cena!
It rolls through.
Look at the strength of Cena.
Oh, gosh!
Oh, my God! Slater on the shoulders. Tune adjustment. Hook him away. Shoulders down. Got it. Slater's got it.
That was as impressive as anything I've ever seen.
And Otunga's next up for Nexus. Can Cena somehow pull it off? We are back on Monday Night Raw. Impromptu gauntlet matchup. John Cena versus all members of Nexus already, King. Cena's eliminated Heath Slater, but David A-List the Tunga is up now.
Well, John Cena had no alternative if he hadn't accepted this gauntlet match. Well, all Wade Barrett and all of David Otunga and all of Nexus were going to just totally attack Cena.
Wade Barrett has set up shop on top of our announce table. Yeah, looking on.
We've seen one of those pack of dogs at Nexus attacks before. They would have been annihilated, John.
Suplex by Otunga, likes his work. Maybe he should have really went into the cover there, but I guess he would just like to punish Cena as he looks to the leader of Nexus, Barrett, for approval.
I don't know about you, but I just feel really uncomfortable with this. Wade Barrett hovering over us like this.
You should, Ken. You know firsthand what Nexus is capable of. Suplex again by Otunga. Into the cover now. Hook of the leg. Shoulders. Kick out by Cena. John Cena vowed that the winds of change would stop tonight. As you see Otunga mocking Cena. Tarver, Gabriel next as they look on.
And every second that Cena lasts in there, or David Otunga lasts, is just taking more and more out of John.
This is a small package. Could have him here.
He does.
Cena stole one. He needed it. But Cena's showing the damage is being done by Nexus. Slater, Otunga eliminated. Michael Tarver on his way to the ring. And this guy's one bad dude. Throws a mean right hand. Oh, he's in a bitter mood.
Ready, Cena, come on.
And also what's interesting is you just noticed over on the right-hand side of your screen moments ago, the other members of Nexus still hanging out here. You see Otunga and Slater in the background. Barrett on the announce table. Tarver going right after Cena. That feral dog mentality that has been bred into these members of Nexus.
Oh, it's David Otunga with those lefts and rights into the midsection and ribcage of John Cena.
He's pounding
John outlast these guys. I don't think it's possible.
Wearing Cena down. John Cena. And look at Cena putting in the STL. Submission maneuver. Submission maneuver. Tarver taps. Tarver taps. Cena has eliminated Slater, Otunga, Tarver. Justin Gabriel's next. And Gabriel and Cena have tied it up a number of times in the past. And there's some of that high explosive offense. The style of Gabriel. Hook to the leg. Shoulders down. Two count kick out. Wade Barrett cheering Gabriel on.
I don't know, even if somehow John Cena is successful here against Justin Gabriel, he'll have nothing left for Wade Barrett. That'll be,
Cena cannot afford this. He cannot allow Gabriel to start flying around the ring. Two count, got it, no, kick out again. Cena quickly reaches for the ropes. He gets tangled up in those ropes to buy himself some time. Wade Barrett would be next for Cena.
I mean, he'll just go in there and pick the bones, pick up the pieces. However you want to say it, it's not going to be good for John. Uh-oh, watch this.
What does Gabriel have planned here? Top rope. Moonsault connects.
Grief.
Hook of the leg again. This should be it. No, Cena.
And Gabriel cannot believe that that didn't put John Cena away.
Time and time again, John Cena kicks out of that. And how he does it, I have no idea. I can't believe he survived that moonsault. Gabriel, though, has got him right where he wants him, King.
And the longer Justin Gabriel lasts, the longer Cena stays in that ring, the easier it's going to be for Wade Barrett.
Assuming that Cena can beat Justin. Blocked by Cena. Nice suplex by John. But again, has the physicality in this matchup taken its toll? The fourth man Cena's had to face here in our main event tonight, with perhaps Barrett looming. Cena crawling to the cover. Gets there.
Got
hooks the leg. Oh, and Gabriel kicks at it, too.
Almost had him.
I'll tell you, King, Nexus has done so much to John Cena over the past number of months. Oh. Cost him the WWE title on so many different occasions.
And that's why when we got here, John Cena was really looking forward to a one-on-one match with Wade Barrett.
Now, you had to know Barrett had something up his sleeve, though. It's the M.O. Oh, Gabriel planting Cena. Cena down and out. Whoa. He still powers out. And what's surprising about that kick out, King, almost like Cena had a little more energy. Wade powered out of that near fall.
Wade Barrett getting a little bit frustrated here.
Back to his feet.
Incoming.
Gabriel.
Whoa.
Cena ducks underneath. Uh-oh, shoulder knocked out. Momentum shift coming.
Oh, look at this.
Down. Cena.
Cena has reached down deep. He's eyeing Wade Barrett. How about a little five-knuckle shuffle? Oh, and for Cena. Justin Gabriel.
Cena can feel like he's closing in on knocking off. Hey, look at him.
Hey, wait a minute.
Otunga. Hey. Tarver. You just knew this was coming. You could feel it coming. Nexus lying in wait. And Wade Barrett, steel chair in hand. Cena cuts him off with the pass.
And Cena's got the chair.
Cena with the chair.
Cena with the chair.
The equalizer. Nexus scatters.
Well, you know, now it's a good thing Wade Barrett brought that chair in the ring. That was the only way John Cena was able to hold those jackals at bay. Nexus totally frustrated. Barrett can't believe it.
So the way I see it, you owe me. Right now, John Cena versus Wade Barrett. We end it now.
You know what? That's quite the offer, Cena. But to be perfectly honest with you, I don't think I've got anything to gain from laying you to waste once more. So if I am going to face you, I'm going to need a little something to sweeten the deal.
Name it. Name it. Whatever you want. This match happens. Whatever you want. Name it.
You know, I think I actually have just the ticket. You know, Cena, you like to claim that you will do anything for the WWE Universe. You'll put it all on the line. Well, how's about this time you actually put yourself on the line? We've been here before, Cena. I've tried to recruit you in the past, and you threw it back in my face. Well, this time I want it to be a little bit different. This time, I'm going to take the choice out of your hands.
What are you talking about?
Cena, I'll fight you. I'll fight you one-on-one. In fact, I will fight you in 2 weeks' time at the Hell in a Cell pay-per-view. On one condition.
Like I said, cut to the chase. What do you want?
Such a rush, Cena. Well, here's what I want. I beat you. You become a part of this. No ifs, no buts, no maybes, no excuses, and certainly no escape clauses. If I win, John Cena joins the Nexus.
Cena, part of Nexus?
You think I'm going to back down from a fight with you? You're on. What?
It's a pleasure doing...
Hey! Whoa! We're going to make this big. We got to make this big. I am putting my lifeblood on the line, and you just show up... So here's what happens if I win. If I win, Nexus is done. Oh, I don't mean the Nexus has been weakened. I don't mean the Nexus's foundation has been shaken.
Don't you get clever with me.
I mean, Tarver goes back to Macy's and selling women's fragrances. I mean, Gabriel goes back to work at the Twinkie factory as a cream filler. I mean, Otunga goes back to mooching off his wife. Actually, hey, David, don't worry about it. Nothing's really going to change for you. I mean, Slater goes back to working at Wendy's as the chick from Wendy's. And I mean, the great Wade Barrett goes down in history. Not as leader of the Nexus, but as winner of NXT Season 1. The man with a golden opportunity, the world in his hand, the guy who flushed it down the toilet. You want to do this? Put something on the line. Hell in a Cell, you win, I join Nexus. I win. Nexus is done, bud. Did the stakes just get a little too big for you? Did the WWE Universe just call your bluff? What's it gonna be